This part of the CD will be called Build Up. In this part, we will be putting together a part of your plan called the Build Up Stage. In this part of the CD, you'll be challenged to go deeper than what you had before. That's why I'm playing a song called Deeper by the Gospel House. Again, the song is Deeper by the Gospel House. We're going to take about 45 seconds to a minute and just listen to it. Come on, somebody, just tell him you reach for her. Oh, that's it. Hallelujah. Come on, do you thirst for him? Thirst. Oh, that's it. Somebody, just worship him. For he's mighty to be saved. Oh, yes, he is mighty to be seen. Oh, glory, glory, glory. Oh, glory, glory, glory. You are mighty to seen. And now with that said, I want to go into the Bible for about 45 seconds and read some scriptures. This is coming from the New Living Translation. Luke 17, starting at verse 1. One day Jesus said to his disciples, "There will be temptations to sin, but what sorrow awaits the person who does the tempting? It would be better to be thrown into the sea with a millstone hung around your neck than to cause one of these little ones to fall into sin. So watch yourselves. If another believer sins, rebuke that person then. If there is repentance, forgive. Even if that person wrongs you 7 times a day, and each time turns again and asks for forgiveness, you must forgive." That's coming from Luke chapter 17, verses 1 through 4. Again, that's Luke chapter 17, verses 1 through 4, out of the New Living Translation. I want to talk to you more in depth right now about I want to talk to you more in depth right now about the build-up stage. What the build-up stage is looking back at your triggers. I'm gonna give you some examples of a trigger, and we're gonna walk through the build-up stage together. A trigger could be somebody said something smart to you. They cussed at you. They cussed your mother out. And you retaliated and fought them back. You see, the startup was you becoming triggered by the person that cussed your mom out. You turned around and retaliated by fighting them. That was the build-up stage. The build-up stage is responsible by us. We control it. In other words, the build-up stage is how we choose to react. You can choose to react by going out here and fighting somebody and killing them, or you can choose to remove yourself, get up and walk off, take a Bible and read it, and calm yourself down. You see, many teenagers go through this world, and we are often faced with trials. And then when we are faced with these temptations, we do not know how to give up on them. We fall right into the trap of the enemy. We fall right into the trap of that person. For they know what tests us, they know what triggers us. But yep, we fall right into it time and time again. That's why in this CD, you're going to be challenged to create a plan, to take a stand. Hallelujah. I can just feel something getting ready to shift in your life. That's it. It's time to say no to the devil, no to everybody else, and focus right on you. This is a period of learning about yourself so that you can grow into the kingdom of God and where God has called you. But it doesn't start until we start this process of developing the breaking process. So with that said, I want to leave you with three questions. I'm going to give you time to go back and get that notebook that you're going to need. You can use your iPad, you can use your note section in your phone or cell phone, whatever. Make sure you write it down. Today's questions, or the questions for this part of the CD, are: 1. Choose one of your triggers. How did you respond? Did you fight them back? Did you avoid it? 2. If you fought back, if you retaliated, if you fed in to the other person, how could you have avoided it? Don't put something like walk away. Think of something brighter. Think of something brighter. My last question is, if you could go back and change one thing, what would it do? What would you do differently, and why? You see, many a times in life, we don't take the time to stop and think about anything. We react with impulses. We are very impulsive people that we just react without thinking. And we realize the consequences after the fact. So in this next track, we will be looking at consequences and how they play a part in our life. I told you, it doesn't start till we break the process, and we're breaking it right now. In Jesus' name, amen. I want to pray with you before you change this track. Father, I decree right now in the name of Jesus, Lord, as they continue to listen to this CD, Father, you, O Lord, would nurture them in every way, O Lord. Father, you, O Lord, are already above them, O Lord. Father, you, O Lord, they have God in them, O Lord. For, Father, you know what they struggle with. Father, I ask right now that you be their light, O Lord, in darkness and sickness and health. And, Father, we come together right now for everybody that's struggling, O Lord. Lord, we bind it right now. We bind every spirit of the enemy. We bind every spirit of attack. And Father, I lift up right now in the name of Jesus. For Lord, you, O Lord, are bringing a brighter generation. But y'all, it's time that we break the chains and we take a stand for what we believe in. No more shall the enemy, no more shall others, no more shall our family members, whoever's been putting us down. It's time a new weapon formed against us shall prosper. Hallelujah. Oh, that's it. It's time to break it. It's time to break it. So I leave you with this question. Are you ready to break it? Or are you going to stay stuck where you are? It's time to rise up and go into the kingdom where God has called you. Stop backing down and allow God to have every way he wants. It's time we take a stand for what we believe in. And it's time that we back out of ourselves and we allow God to intervene when we get the urge or we get the desire to react. So with that said, I'll leave you with this last and final question. Are you going to continue to stay stuck, or are you going to continue to allow yourself to be stuck? You got two options: call on God or allow yourself to continue to be stuck. So I'll leave you with this question. Are you going to remain stuck? Are you going to remain where you are? Are you going to remain the person you have been? Do you want to stay that same person? Because if you do, you need to reevaluate the choices that you made. Because many of us have made poor choices in the past, but we have yet to realize the consequences behind them. And that's what we're going to explore in this next part of the CD. Thank you for listening to this, and I look forward to working with you more in depth. God bless.